rather a puny life, because you're making something out of sound and light, which is nothing, you know, and you're trying to craft something that has power and power to connect and move people. So it's a paradox, and that paradox is intoxicating, and I've never lost my love from the very first day I stepped inside a television company to today.
I mentioned it almost inevitably in the introduction.
To offer charity donations instead of presents for his 7th birthday. What a sweetheart. And here he is, Mr. Ken Bruce. How was your weekend, Ken?
Oh, lovely. I've done my back end moving furniture. And apart from that, I think I'll... Well, that's one good reason I won't be able to dance for fun, along with everybody else.
Oh,
getting
excuses.
That's it. And I can't get my sling backs off either.
Spurs' title hopes suffered a setback as they lost 2-1 at Burnley. It finished 1-1 between Wolves and Bournemouth, and Newcastle won 2-0 against Western side Huddersfield. And tonight's weather: any lingering rain will die out in Scotland. Elsewhere, it'll be mainly dry and clear. But
I'm an American electronic music composer and performer based in Berlin, Germany.
3 minutes of Tiffany.
Fawn is my AI baby, and I use baby as a kind of more of a metaphorical device. So Fawn is a artificial intelligence that raises my partner Matt Dryhurst, and Fawn's godmother is Jaylen, and her godfather is Jules LaPlace. With a really strong GPU, and you build a computer, and then you start running various processes. You know, most of the kind of over-the-counter AI that people are using today, they're often coming from academic research institutions or from large tech companies like Google and Microsoft. So we're using a lot of the same algorithms that
people are. Well, if anybody from New York asks, they'd go, yeah. So they were working in London, oh, so they do get around. Working in a prominent London department store, we were remodelling a concession stand on the women's wear floor. A rather attractive lady knocked on the door of the hoarding and explained they had received some new stock items which were too big for the display, they needed modifying. She asked if she could borrow a saw, and without a moment's hesitation, I duly
.co.uk. I'll repeat it for you in about 10 minutes' time. It is a bit involved, I did say, didn't I? If you get that right, you'll get a big radio high five from yours truly. More great new music in from Fast Car to Florence this week. It's called Sick on My Own. I woke up with an aching
My castaway this week is the film director Paul Greengrass, truly a storyteller from modern times. His movies are cultures. Our rugby commentator Chris Jones described the final moments.
One more run. Everyone is on their feet. Look around us. What an atmosphere. Davis, Alec Davis kicks it out. And Wales have won. And Wales' Grand Slam dream lives on. And England's Grand Slam.
The main theme from the original recording of David Lean's Lawrence of Arabia, composed and conducted by Maurice Jarre and performed by the London Philharmonic.
Kathy says, I saw these guys on Saturday with my best gig buddy and they were awesome, and I'm now doing the washing up before work. Ah! Oh, washing up's so annoying, isn't it? It's just, that's my least favourite chore of them all. Ironing, I can take or leave, but washing up is actually the bane of my life. So Kath, my thoughts are with you, but glad you enjoyed that Tomorrow on Pilots gig. Hello to Natasha from Nottingham, who says, my weekend was great. I went out on Friday for my friend's leaving due. She's moving to Vietnam for travelling. She leaves tomorrow, so I just want to wish her all the luck in the world. Love you long time, Luca, says Natasha from Nottingham. Hi to Georgie. Yes, Georgie says, hi, Clara. I ran my first half marathon yesterday in 2 hours and 6 minutes. I'm very sore today. I felt like a powerful woman, though. That's big up to you. I think I used to do a half in about 2 hours. 2 hours. Or maybe 2:20 if I'm feeling extra speedy. Yeah, I think it was a vitality run, wasn't it? Big up to everybody that did that, because half marathons are no joke. I mean, full marathons are no joke either. But... over amending it are deadlocked. It's despite the Prime Minister speaking to the President of the European Commission by telephone last night and a weekend of negotiations between officials. The Chinese Aviation Authority has grounded all the country's Boeing 737 MAX 8 aircraft after the crash in Ethiopia yesterday. Ethiopian Airlines, which operated the plane, has also grounded its entire fleet of 737 MAX 8s. Public Health England is calling for highly polluting vehicles to be discouraged from entering populated areas and for congestion charges to be imposed in cities across the UK. It's warned tens of thousands of deaths a year can be attributed to pollution. A 15-year-old boy has been charged with the murder of Jodie Chesney, the teenager who was stabbed in a park in East London. A 20-year-old man from Romford was remanded in custody on Saturday, charged with the murder. The weather, after a cold start, sunny spells with wintry showers in the north and west gradually dying away. That's the BBC News. Our next at 7. Good morning, Tina. Did you have a lovely weekend? Yes. A lovely weekend, thank you very much.
Excellent.
Can you hear things printing out in the studio?
Can I hear things printing out? If someone said
somebody playing tricks on you again.
It has a mind of its own, it really does.
Is it printing? It's having all the
drinks. Coming out of the printer. Anyway, lovely weekend. Okay. You?
Yeah, lovely weekend. I can't believe it's Monday already. Mm. How did that happen? I'll see you in a minute.
Thanks, trust you had a truly terrific weekend. Would you, Adam and Eve? It's Monday again. How did that happen so fast? Are you ready to go around again? We certainly are. Thank you to Lady V for a gentle awakening for all of us this morning.
Let's do this then.
I love to visit the yew tree at Steventon. It's over 1,000 years old and it's next to the church where Jane Austen's dad used to be the vicar.
I've been downhearted, babe. Ever since the day we met. I say I've been downhearted, babe.
Truly miraculous about your brain, clearly.
Well, no, why? I always think, why wouldn't I? Because if it can help future generations not have this inevitability that a diagnosis currently brings, how wonderful would that be for future generations?
Last week on the podcast, it was a little lowbrow, and I thought we'd go a bit posher, basically, be a bit more intelligent. Last week it was talking of like Fiona's gross mates who fart in pencil cases. This week, we're forgetting about the bodily functions. We're going so highbrow that we even booked an actual professor for the Radio 1 breakfast show.
Yeah, but it was a hungover professor.
Still counts.
A tuna eating sandwich professor.
Still counts. He was a hungover professor, slightly hungover, just a 4 out of 10, which is doable.
Yeah, you can survive.
Still fine, yeah. But anyway, here's what happened when Professor Brian Cox came on the Radio 1 Breakfast Show. Good morning, Professor Brian Cox.
Good morning.
How are you?
Not too bad. Slight hangover.
Slight hangover. Very slight. What out of 10? What is it out of 10?
It's only about a 4.
Oh, okay. That's fine. That's fine. I quite like a 4 out of 10 sometimes.
It focuses the mind, doesn't it?
I think it does. I mean, do drink responsibly, but sometimes producers at Radio 1 say this show is better when I'm hungover,
yeah,
because I'm not distracted.
Yeah.
I'm sort of thinking and focused and thinking, don't get fired! And then the show's quite streamlined. Is there a science to getting over a hangover?
I don't know. Well, what I did was buy a tuna sandwich.
Ooh, was it a toasty or
no,
just a regular?
Okay, look at the stars.
Right. That seems to have worked.
That seems to have worked, and that's...
Pot. These two friends are cycling towards each other at a speed of 6 miles an hour. Each one is travelling at 6 miles an hour together. A budgie flies backwards and forwards.
Including Formula One. He's about to do his first ever Formula One start. All the drivers are now lined up at the front of this Albert Park circuit. The Australian fans are all on their feet.
With full coverage of practice rounds and qualifying.
Max Verstappen then across the line. The sun is flying out. The sparks fly from underneath the Red Bull in the pitch darkness of the Singapore night. Here comes Vettel, faster still.
Plus, live action and analysis from across the F1 calendar.
All five lights are on and the first Grand Prix of the season is go.
France beat Scotland 27-10. Football and in the Premier League, Spurs' title hopes suffered a setback as they lost 2-1 at Burnley. It finished 1-1 between Wolves and Bournemouth, and Newcastle won 2-0 against bottom side Huddersfield.